There's part of the crowd here. Let's have a look at the tail of the tape. Kostya Zoo, 15 and Zit, 11 by KO. Pineda, 27, 21 wins by TKO. Kostya's 26, Pineda 24. And here's where the advantage is way up for the visitor, the challenger, the Colombian. 186 centimetres, almost 20 centimetres height advantage over Kostya Zoo. The weight is similar, although reports today are that following yesterday's weigh-in, that Pineda will actually hop into the ring this evening at something like 70 kilos. So he has certainly got the weight advantage, the height advantage, and the IBF rules tonight, the 10-point must system, 3-knockdown rule is not in effect. There's no standing 8 count. And a boxer can be saved by the bell in any round, and there will be a standing 8 count. So here comes the Colombian, Hugo Pineda, behind the blue and gold Colombian flag. So the challenger on to Parramatta Stadium first here on what has been already a dramatic evening here at Parramatta Stadium for the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World.
Peter, the Colombian was given a raucous reception when he arrived at the airport, the international airport here in Sydney. There were two or three dozen Colombians waving flags and shouting. He's had tremendous support here, said he really enjoys the people that he's met here in Australia, and he has great support here in the crowd as well.
There he is, Hugo Pineda, working up a sweat in the dressing room before the biggest fight of his night against the Russian-born, Australian naturalised, Kostya Zoo.
It was interesting. He does look very relaxed. He was saying that he feels less pressure having the fight here in Sydney than he would have if the fight went ahead in November in Cartagena in Colombia. And he's also making a stack more money here as well. His brother is a former Colombian amateur champion. He is himself a Colombian and Latin American champion. And he turned pro at 19 years of age, unbeaten in 28 fights. He certainly has the credentials, but I just wonder whether or not he's going to have the power to do any damage on Kostya Zoo.
Well, there he is in center ring now, Hugo Pineda, and he has got a wonderful height and reach advantage over Kostya Zoo. But whether or not that's going to be to his advantage when they actually start fighting is debatable, because Kostya's like a pit bull up against the well, he's like a daddy long legs, isn't he? Very thin legs, Pineda. I watched him in the gym during the week, and I couldn't believe the thinness of his legs. There are a couple of celery sticks. He looks like a two-iron with ears and boxing gloves. But Kostya Zoo, more the pit bull type. And here comes Kostya through the tunnel with the accompanying world title belt. Kostya, this is only the second defence of his title that he won almost 12 months ago. So he's been very much inactive, surprisingly. And that's been a bone of contention with a lot of boxing fans as to why Kostya Zoo has only had one defence of his title in just 12 months when he hasn't been injured. Sure, he was to go to Colombia and that fight did not take place. But in the eyes of many, he should have had a lot more fights as world champion than he's had today.
Well, there's no doubt about that, Peter. I think the good news is that according to Johnny Lewis, we will see him in action at least three or four times this year. His last performance, his first defence against Roger Mayweather, went the distance. He was less than impressive in that fight. Although when he took the title from Jake Rodriguez, who incidentally is also a southpaw, he had him down with inside 20 seconds with a crisp right. He also had him down with the left hand as well, and that only went six rounds. Kostya Zoo has been waiting a long time to defend this title here in Sydney. He gets his chance, and rated by Boxing Illustrator's Budweiser's international rankings, the pound for pound rankings, Kostya at 15 is ahead of the likes of Nigel Benn and Riddick Bowe and James Toney. He does have the credentials, you would think, to beat this Colombian, but
here he goes with his traditional jump into the ring, Kostya Zoo. And there's the crowd. The zoos go up here at Parramatta Stadium. And a good crowd in attendance, and we're going to go into centre ring now for the official introductions with our ring announcer, Mark Warren.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Colombia. To sing the best song in the world, please make welcome Miss Nadine Flick.
Australians, all let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing. The seas with boundless plagues to share. With courage, let us all combine to advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing. Advance Australia fair.
Set down for 12 3-minute rounds. Your timekeeper, Alex Fraser. Knockdown timekeeper, Gary Lowe. IBF supervisor, Mr. John McDougall. Ringside physicians, Dr. Lou and Alex Lewis. Judges ringside, Ray Wheatley, Australia. Joe Garcia, USA. Rocky Garcia, Colombia. And your referee, Mr. Billy Males. This bout is under the control of the International Boxing Federation. No standing 8-count will apply. The 3-knockdown rule is not in effect. The bell cannot save a boxer in any round. The time has come. It's fight time at the stadium. Firstly, the challenger. He comes with the hopes of a nation. with renowned trainer who has trained 10 world champs, including the great Carlos Monzon. Weighing in at 63.25 kilograms and age 27, he stands at 6'1" with a reach to match. His professional record reads 28 bouts, 27 wins, 1 draw, 21 KOs. Managed by Billy Chams, the southpaw, the challenger, Hugo Panida. Ladies and gentlemen, the blue corner. Born in Serov at the base of the Ural Mountains in Russia. Now from Brighton, Sydney, New South Wales, Australia. Weighing in at 63.35 kilograms. Sporting black trunks and pigtail. Trained at the Factory of Champions under master trainer Johnny Lewis at the Newtown Police Boys Club. He has an amateur career of 270 fights for 259 wins. Taking the professional ranks by storm, he took the title from Jake the Snake Rodriguez in America of January 1995. The undefeated king of junior welterweight, Sting, the baby-faced assassin, Costa Zoo.
We're ready to go at Parramatta Stadium. Costa Zoo and Hugo Pineda for the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World. Costa Zoo out of the blue corner in the black trunks. Hugo Pineda out of the red corner in the white and blue trunks. Billy Males is the referee, round one. The Colombian will want to stay away from Zoo early in the fight. Zoo has got dynamite in both hands, but the reach and height advantage of the Colombian should be his greatest asset. Zoo goes after him though. A banging right from Costa Zoo, and the Colombian hangs on.
It was only a matter of time, Peter. He was looking for the target. He bided his time, and they're in close again.
And now it's a wrestle.
By some power in that right hand. It's a paralysing right hand from Costa Zoo.
The southpaw, the right hand of Pineda, should be his bread and butter. He's got to keep Zoo away from him in the early rounds, because Costa, his record and his class, can put away any opponent. And Zoo goes after him with a short banging right. The eye of the tiger tonight, Costa Zoo, in his adopted country. Pineda, oh, right by Zoo, and he buckled him there. Pineda's got to beat him to the puncher and end up right on his backside. Left and right by Pineda, right by Pineda. Zoo walking through them, cocking that right, looking to land the dynamite punch that we know he's got.
There's no doubt he's at his most dangerous in the early rounds, Peter. He's undefeated since 1989, and also had his Russian trainer Vladimir Chernia out here in Australia in the build-up to this fight.
Okay, Pineda now trying to work that right to Zoo. Zoo wrestles his taller opponent, but Pineda hangs on. Billy Males like a tiger in there. Warns Pineda.
Well, the Colombian hasn't had the opportunity of throwing too many punches just yet. He's too intent on backpedaling.
What I've seen so far, he's not going to... Oh, Zoo goes down to the neutral corner. He's putting a... Costa Zoo's just looked at Johnny Lewis and said, I'm okay. Well, there's a shot. Costa Zoo down in round one. It was a very quick punch from Pineda, and down went Zoo. He winked at Johnny Lewis in the corner and said, I'm OK.
He's gone again, Peter, he's gone.
Another good left hand there from the Colombian, and Kostya Zoo.
Yeah, and looking in real trouble at the moment, Kostya Zoo, towards the end of the first round. Round one, 22 seconds remaining in the round. Shannon Taylor has joined us at ringside, and a dramatic start to this fight.
The shock to the start of the fight, Peter, but a lot of money went on the Colombian this afternoon, and he said he, you know, means business, and it looks like he does.
Well, too early to tell yet, but there's the end of round one. Kostya Zoo going to the corner after being put down in sensational circumstances in the opening round by Hugo Pineda. There's the corner of Kostya Zoo. He looked stunned when he went down, and the referee, Billy Miles, had no doubt that it was a clean punch.
Well, it was definitely a punch, and Billy Miles...
Let's have a look at the replay. I'm pretty sure it was a short left from Pineda that Zoo walked into. No, it was the right. It was a stunning right from Hugo Pineda, and Kostya Zoo with his mouth open and looking absolutely daggers at his opponent. It was the right from Pineda from low down, right on the button of Kostya Zoo, and down went Zoo. He was wide open to the right, and it was right on the button. A windy woofer of a punch, but it had the desired effect.
Well, it landed right on the sweet spot, and that was right on the tip of the chin.
Yeah, it certainly was. Round two underway now, and Zoo with a bit of work to do. After being down in round one, and a desperate Kostya Zoo. Gee, the difference in height is amazing between these two competitors.
Well, when he lacks in height, Kostya certainly makes up for in determination, but he's going to need a lot of it.
He looks as though he's lost his equilibrium a little bit. He's going right after Pineda, and I don't think he's giving him the respect that maybe he thinks he deserves.
He's biting the mouth guard, Kostya Zoo. He really wants to get at him.
Yeah, he certainly does. The mouth's open, and he's ready to go. Pineda, a knockdown of Zoo in the opening round.
Wife Natasha there in the bottom right of your screen obviously hasn't seen this type of action in round one for Kostya before. The Colombian looking very dangerous.
Well, Case, it's usually Kostya putting them down early in the first round, and no, I think it's a shock to himself.
Certainly is, and Kostya Zoo going after Hugo Pineda. Pineda.
He's taking them punches well, Pineda.
He has.
He's handling everything Kostya's throwing at him at the moment.
Kostya Zoo coming on strongly, though, and I think that'll precipitate the little bloke into some action. He's looking up. He's going to get a sore neck by the end of the fight. Looking up at Pineda up in the heavens. Good short right by Kostya Zoo, but Pineda hangs on. Right lead by Pineda. Right lead again by Pineda. He's a southpaw, so that's his bread and butter punch. Left by Pineda to follow the right. He's got the right-left combination going. Ah, great left by Kostya Zoo. And back went the head of Pineda.
And Kostya's settling into the fight now, Peter.
He certainly is. Pineda hanging on. He's an awkward tall thing, isn't he? Hugo Pineda and Kostya Zoo, round two. Zoo down in round one, and the right again from Pineda, a good punch. Left and right by Pineda, right over the top by Kostya Zoo. In close is Kostya. Right to the body by Zoo, and that buckled up the Colombian. Left and right, oh, and back he goes. Kostya Zoo stalking his opponent. The crowd roaring him on. Listen to the roar. Zoo, zoo, zoo. As Kostya goes after Hugo Pineda. Right by Kostya Zoo. Right by Pineda.
He's starting to find his mark, Kostya Zoo. A much better fight than we all thought it was going to be.
Well, already showing the earmarks of a very good contest. Loading up with the riders, Kostya Zoo having difficulty getting at the tall Colombian. End of round two.
End of round two.
There's Johnny Lewis in the corner of Kostya Zoo, and it'd be a worried corner at the moment. Down in round one. Losing round one. And now a eye, bit of a swelling and a graze above the eye of the left eye of Kostyazoo. Very interesting contest so far, John Casey.
Well, absolutely dynamic start from the Colombian. Zoo down in round one. Extraordinary scenes here at Parramatta Stadium in Sydney. He came back there in round two. I gave him the round on my scorecard. But the Colombian, as Shannon Taylor pointed out, seemed to be taking the best of Costia's punches and didn't seem too affected.
This is where the height and reach difference is really obvious. Look at the size of the Colombian. Costia's got to throw a punch almost perpendicular to hit the Colombian in the clinches. Round three, live, the IBF World Championship fight here in the junior welterweight division. Round three at Parramatta Stadium, and it's a war. There's not much science to this one so far.
Well, Costia will work hard and get inside. That's where he's going to be making an impact. He wants to try and negate the reach and height advantage of his opponent. And he's all action here, certainly taking the fight to the Colombian.
I'm a little surprised at Costia's tactics after being down in round one. I've never seen him panic before, but he looks as though he's rushing things in this fight, Shannon Taylor.
Yeah, he has to settle down a little bit and just take his time and pick his shots. You know, that's what he's good at. And something that hasn't happened to him before in the professional ranks, and it's new to him.
Well, the mouth's open and he's charging in like a bull at a gate. I just think he needs to come back a peg or two and start to fight the fight the way he wanted to. There's a right by Kostyazoo now. Moving in after Pineda. A left by Zoo, but Pineda keeps him away with that right. Kostya's got to almost jump in at his taller opponent.
What's he here?
The Colombian has to use that right lead. He has to throw the right lead out a little more. He's letting Costia get on top of him. Trying to use that reach advantage.
Well, Costa's onto him like a little pit bull, isn't he? He's charging after him. Pineda doesn't have to send a search party out. Kostyazoo nails him with a short right cross.
Oh, stinging right hand there from Kostyazoo. That grabbed the attention of the Colombian. And now he's looking as though he's in a little bit of trouble as well.
Yeah, he certainly went back on his haunches there. One warning, don't hold Pineda. Referee Billy Miles won't cop any rubbish in there. Kostyazoo coming after his opponent, but a good right hand forces him away by Pineda, the Colombian, the challenger for Kostyazoo's IBF Junior Welterweight title. Zoo leads with the left, now with the right.
The Colombian's letting Costa get off first. I feel that he has to use his reach.
No doubt about that. Costia pursuing his opponent. Good round by Zoo. A stinging right by Zoo. And a left by Kostyazoo. Pineda in the red corner and in trouble. Backing away. 28 seconds remaining in round three. Kostyazoo looking for the big one. Bang goes over the top of Pineda. Pineda ducking at the right time. A left in close by Kostyazoo. A stinging left. The Colombian hanging on for dear life. Ah, good short left by Kostyazoo. Following it up with the right.
He's starting to pick his punches now, Kostyazoo.
Yeah, a lot more control towards the end of that round was Kostyazoo. End of round three.
Last week, of course, that Frankie Randall lost his WBA Junior Welterweight Championship of the World to Juan Coggi. Perhaps that is a good sign for the Colombian here. Perhaps we're going to see the second new Junior Welterweight Champion of the World inside a week.
Here's a replay of some of the action. Costia getting inside, trying to unsettle the Colombian, and he's certainly doing that. That was a much better round, Shannon Taylor, for Kostyazoo.
Oh, yeah, the fight's starting to swing Costa's way, but I spoke to the Colombian camp during the week, and they Seven believe down. From five onwards, it's going to be their fight.
Well, I don't know about that. He's remaining on his stool. The Colombian, Kostyazoo in centre ring. He grabbed every moment. Pineda in his corner. And Zoo is there to meet him. And down goes a Colombian. A short right by Costa Zoo. And down goes Pineda in the early stages of round four. Can he see out the round? A stinging short right by Costa Zoo. Coming after Pineda. This is a courageous effort by Zoo after being down in round one.
Australia's first world title fight in over 5 years, and it's a cracker.
Oh, he's going to be gone. Pineda, he's wobbly. Gone. The right again by Costa Zoo. He's had him down in the opening stages of the round. Pineda fighting back. Again a right from Costa. One on the button, I think, will do it for the Colombian. Pineda fighting back.
He's got a big heart.
As an amateur and as a professional.
He's got a big heart, the Colombian.
He's going to need it before this night's over. A very worried Colombian camp now. They were cock-a-hoop after round one, and now in the early stages, halfway through really, round four, Pineda looks in real trouble. It was a glorious crisp right hand from Costa Zoo that sent the Colombian to the canvas.
One thing about Costa, he loves to fight southpaws. He doesn't have any problem at all, Peter.
Well, I'm amazed that the height and reach of the Colombian isn't being used to greater advantage. But he can't keep Costa away. He's all over him, Costa Zoo.
The Colombian's doing roundhouse punches. He should be using the long punches.
And Pineda now starting to fight the fight that Costa Zoo wants. Pineda hasn't really fought a lot outside of Colombia, and I think the experience of Zoo through that great amateur career and into the professional ranks, he's a true champion, and he's showing it here tonight at Parramatta Stadium. Coming off the deck in round one, putting Pineda down in the early stages of round four, a knockdown each, and Costa Zoo assuming control in this one. Ah, left and right combination by Zoo. Pineda's done well to virtually see out the round. 27 seconds left in round four. Costa fighting a much more controlled fight now. Left and right by Pineda. Zoo taking one on the right-hand side of the face. Another stinging blow from the Colombian. Though every now and then, the Colombian praying mantis getting through the defense of Costa Zoo. Oh, right on the nose from Costa Zoo. And that stopped him in his tracks. And he is tough, Pineda, because he should have gone down there. A great round, round four to Costa Zoo. A terrific round for Costa Zoo, Shannon Taylor.
Well, that was a very good round for Costa Zoo. He'd have to have won that by 10-8, a very good round, and the fight's swinging his way.
Let's have a look at the knockdown from Costa Zoo. Down went Pineda. It happened very quickly there. The right it was. Definitely the right from Costa Zoo. Only a short one, and it did the damage. Right on the button from Costa Zoo. There it is. It was almost a repeat of it there, and it's the punch that Costa has used to great effect in his career so far.
That's right. It was the winning punch against Jake the Snake Rodriguez, and Costa Zoo just has a phenomenal will to win. He has the desire, and he is the world champion. He won't give it up without a fight, and he's stalking the Colombian straight away as we start round five.
John Case, is becoming a good fight, isn't it?
This is an excellent fight, Shannon. There is no doubt about that. We didn't know what to expect from the Colombian. Costa Zoo, 7-1 on with bookmakers, unbackable odds. And here is the Colombian having him down in round one and trying to go to work here in round five.
Well, he is a good fighter and he's a champion, Costa. He got off the deck in the first and he swung the fight around his own way.
There, he certainly has a terrific performance in round five, and Costa Zoo now in the driver's seat in this fight. Left and right again by the Colombian.
Colombian boxing a little more this round.
Yeah, he certainly is.
He should have been doing that the last few.
Round five, scheduled to go 12 for the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World.
Oh, that's a good punch. That was a good punch by Kostazu. Kostazu's like a dog of a bone.
Here he certainly is.
It's going to be a good fight when we fight later in the year, Peter.
You think it'll be this year?
Oh, I hope so. Bill Morty reckons about November.
Number one promoter in Australia, Bill Morty, of course. And took Kostazu to a world title, and here he is defending it.
I reckon it's going to be great having two Australians fight for an IBF world title.
1 point off here. Okay, third warning from referee Billy Miles. Lobo, 1 point off for the Colombian Hugo Pineda. So he's really digging his own hole here at Parramatta Stadium.
That's not going to help his cause, although he did collect Kostia with a solid punch when referee Billy Miles stepped in there.
I think he caught him by surprise in round one. It was a punch that was thrown from nowhere, and it caught Kostia by surprise. Certainly not catching him by surprise now. 29 seconds remaining in round five.
It's a far better fight than everybody expected. The Colombian's got plenty of heart.
Yeah, he certainly has. Very, very good round again for Kostazu, who's in the driver's seat in this fight. And I don't think there's any doubt, Shannon Taylor, that he's going to retain his title here tonight.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. He's winning on the scorecards. He's definitely winning on mine. And it amazes me that he has no problem at all with southpaws, none whatsoever.
No, he's handling his opponent with ease. And here's that low punch from Hugo Pineda. Let's look at it now. There it goes. Oh, right into the crotch area, and it's 1 point off.
Kostazu is bleeding from the left ear as well. Some concern by Johnny Lewis in the blue corner with Kostazu.
Seconds down, round six.
He does appear to be lucid. He's quickly to his feet. The Colombian, in contrast, still down on his haunches. He's up now. Round six action here. Kostazu defending the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World. Down in round one, he is fighting his way back, and at least on my score, card now is in front.
Here's Kostazu with the right now, and sensation here at ringside. Would you believe that Shannon Taylor, who has been a guest commentator for Premier All-Star Sports for every fight we've had, is now virtually been tried to be removed here from ringside. A sensation at ringside here with Vlad Wharton, the promoter of Kostazu, and the politics in Australian boxing stink. Now, you know, Shannon has done a marvellous job. He's constructively looked at this fight, and they want to have him removed. He's staying with us. If he's moved, it'll be through the security. So a sensation here at ringside, and a sensation in the ring too. You'll read and hear a lot more about it too.
It's just sad, Peter, we're all businessmen and we're all professionals, and I'm just sad that this is the first world title fight I've got to commentate, and I wanted to enjoy the night no matter who it's.
Well, you enjoy it, mate, and don't worry about that sort of thing. Politics is something that you can stay right out of. Let's all stay out of it, and let's get on with the fight here. Kostazu doing a great job against Hugo Pineda.
He's got a sharp right hand, Kostazu. That's beautiful punching. The Colombian's still there. He's taken everything Costa's thrown.
1 minute 20 remaining in round six of this contest.
Well, again, he went downstairs and Billy Miles had to step in and point the finger.
I beat the guys at the Oakey Country Club Hotel. I bet Oakey, Bill Ryan, I just signed him up this week for Premier Sports. I bet they're enjoying this one.
I bet they are. And welcome to all our new Premier All-Star Sports channels around the nation. Oh, great right touches him.
He's gone.
Wobbly Pineda.
He's in trouble.
He's hanging on for dear life at the moment. The right again from the little pit bull, Koshyazoo. He's throwing them at will now.
Another warning for a low blow.
Another warning for a low blow, but he's biting, he's buying some time. Hugo Pineda, a left by Koshyazoo this time. Pineda now being cut down by Koshyazoo. Right by Zoo, he's wobbly, and those matchstick legs look like caving in at any moment. What a fight this is. Parramatta Stadium, the venue, the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World.
And this has turned out to be a ripper.
Well, it certainly has. Out comes the mouth guard of Koshyazoo. Round six to Koshyazoo, and I've got no doubt that he leads in this fight now by a fairly comfortable margin, John Casey.
On my card by 3 points, Peter, and it's interesting, his first defence of this crown against Roger Mayweather. He was criticised for being lacklustre, and well, he's really turned it around here. This has been very impressive to pick himself off the canvas in round one and then just dominate this Colombian. It's a very impressive display.
Yeah, it certainly is. I mean, we know Costa is a class act, and he's showing that again here tonight. Let's evaluate Channon, though, constructively. The Colombian, I mean, he really hasn't shown a lot. He's got a tremendous height and reach advantage, and he's not displaying it.
That's correct, Peter. He's not using it. He seems to be throwing roundhouse punches at Costa. I'd be using long, straight punches to keep Costa away from me.
Koshyazoo in the office at the moment. A short right by Zoo. He seems to be hitting the Colombian at will now.
Punch off, come on, punch it away.
Oh, it's low again. That was a little bit south of the border.
Yeah, and Koshyazoo complains.
And again,
another
and again.
Blow. He could disqualify him.
It'd be a shame to see an IBF world title with a disqualification.
Well, he's well behind. Well, there's a warning from Billy Miles. A right by Koshyazoo. Gee, you wonder how he'd get down that low to hit Costa in the crotch area. He's got to get out about 5 feet.
The trouble is that Costa is just relentless at the moment, coming forward, and the Colombian doing everything he can just to keep him at bay. Zoo, though, the warrior, walking in.
Low again.
Low punches again from the Colombian. Billy Miles shakes his head. He's very close to stopping this.
And well, he might, because they are low blows. Koshyazoo, though, giving as good as he gets. In close.
Smile from Koshyazoo.
Oh, he's well in control now.
Oh, good right by Zoo. Left by Zoo.
He's definitely fit to come in. He came here 2 weeks before the fight, and you know, he said he came here to take the title away, and he's definitely, he's trained hard, and he's wanted to do that, but Costa ain't going to let him.
No, he just lacks a little bit of class, I think, and Costa's not going to be denied tonight. I don't think the Colombian's punches, even the one that put him down in round one, Costa signaled to Johnny Lewis he wasn't hurt.
I think Costa's more disappointed that he got caught, Peter.
Yeah, I think so too. It was... He walked into it more than anything else.
Blood now trickling from the nose of the Colombian. Zoo also bleeding from the left ear. It's been rough and ready. And it will be interesting to see how Costa goes through this middle
right, right.
round.
And what a right. He's ready to go. The tree is ready to fall. He's hanging on for dear life. Hugo Pineda, 23 seconds left in round seven. Right to the body by Zoo. Ah, great right, Koshyazoo. Oh, And oh, what a saviour! Round seven, another knockdown for Kostya Zou. And Zou, raining blows at will now on the tall Colombian. And Hugo Pineda, a sick and sorry sight in his corner, definitely saved then by the bell.
And both times it's been that crushing right hand from Kostya Zou. Down in round four, the Colombian, and down again in round seven. Zou now with a comfortable lead, but you would have to think this will not go the 12 rounds.
Okay, let's have a look at the knockdown from Kostya Zou. Oh, banging right from Kostya Zou. And that was a dynamite punch. Look at Pineda swinging like a rusty gate in a gale. And the effect of the punch, there it is, down he goes. And that was from that stinging right hand moments before. Look at Pineda and bang, on the button, quick as a flash, Kostya Zou. Zou,
seven's down,
ready to go, on his toes. Pineda, a forlorn figure now, on his chair as he comes out now for round eight.
It's going to be all over very soon.
Yeah, I've got to agree. A very impressive performance this. After being down in round one, we've had a knockdown of Pineda by Kostya Zou. After being down himself in round one, he's put Pineda down in round four and round seven.
Doesn't want much to do with the fight at the moment, the Colombian.
No, I think one good one from Kostya now might end this fight. He sort of went down as an after effect of that right in the last round. I think he realises that this long journey, which was to have been fought in his own backyard, he's come to Parramatta Stadium in Sydney, Australia, and he's come a long way to find out that Kostya Zou is a worthy world champion.
Kostya doesn't like it. That was low again. He eyeballs the Colombian, looking for the target.
He's too good a sport to give him one back, but Kostya could give a straight right and it would hit Pineda in the groin. Right above us now, in the neutral corner, Kostya Zou with the eye of the tiger. The little pit bull.
He ran into one then.
He ran into one again, you're right. A right hand by Pineda, a right again by Kostya Zou.
They're both very, very fit men. They've trained very hard for this fight.
A left and right by Kostya Zou. Dropping the guard now, willing the Colombian to come to him. Dropping the guard and willing Pineda. He's saying, come and have a shot if you're good enough. Kostya beating him into the punch now. The Colombian on the back foot, another right, and he staggered him again. Kostya Zou and Hugo Pineda. A two-man war at Parramatta Stadium.
After right in, he just keeps running into the Colombian.
Ah, oh, there's a great left from Zou, mixing it up a bit.
Another low blow.
I'm surprised Kostya hasn't worked to the body a bit more. The end of round
That's
eight.
The end of round number eight.
Another good round for Kostya Zou. Definitely in the vanguard of this fight now. I'm a little surprised, Shannon Taylor, that he hasn't moved more to the body area now of Hugo Pineda.
Yeah, that's what I'd be doing. That'd be my attack, to get to the body and bring him down. You know, he's a tall man. It's like you said, just throw a straight right hand would be to his body, but I thought he would have chopped him down through the centre and brought him down.
Okay, there's Kostya Zou in his corner, Johnny Lewis. A lot more confident than he was after round one. Kostya settled down a lot more and I think he's fighting the fight the way he wants it now. Early on, he appeared to be like a bull at a gate, didn't he?
That's right, Peter. He was stung into action, really, by that knockdown, the Colombian putting him down in round one, much to the shock of everyone here. But he has been criticised in the past for losing his power in the rounds through 9, 10, 11. We'll see how he goes.
Okay, we're into the ninth round now. Kostya Zou and Hugo Pineda for the IBF Junior Welterweight title. There's been knockdowns in three of the rounds. Zou was down in round one. Pineda in rounds 4 and 7. I'm surprised, pleasantly surprised, that Pineda got through that round 8, because I thought at the end of round 7 that he had signified that he'd just about had enough. So it's a good performance for him to continue in the fight. I don't think he's got a ghost chance of winning it, but he's brave as they come.
It all comes down to the hard training that these two guys have done. You know, they're great athletes.
Yeah, they certainly are. Look at little Kostya. He's moving and trying to get out. He's so strong in close. A right by Pineda.
Well, he's brave and courageous, the Colombian. You're right, Peter. He went down in round 7, almost delayed reaction. It was almost as if he didn't want to continue. But since then, he's certainly improved. Very gutsy performance.
Yeah, it has been. It's a real war in close. They're both hanging on for dear life. Pineda clutching Zou at every opportunity. Billy Miles is earning his money tonight.
That was definitely low again. Kostya doesn't like it. And another point has been deducted from the Colombian Hugo Pineda.
And the Colombians are saying that Kostya is pulling his head down. Good sport, Kostya Zou. He hasn't overreacted at all. I don't know whether you'd be as sporty, Shannon Taylor, if you caught that many low blows.
I think I'd have to slip one back, Peter. I don't think I could take that too many liberties in their life.
No. I'm amazed Kostya hasn't.
Mate, but he's doing all right on the chin, so he knows where to keep him.
Yeah. 42 seconds remaining in round 9.
The Colombian's still trying very, very hard.
Starting to connect more than he has in earlier rounds as well. Very brave performance. Zou, though, still storming forward. Working in close, negating the height and reach advantage of the Colombian.
18 seconds remaining. A brawling fight now, this one. The fans have got their money's worth, no doubt about it. The rain almost spoilt the party. What a storm it was earlier. Rain is something of a storm, but so is this. End of round 9.
That rain was just the calm before the storm, I think, Peter.
Well, certainly turning out that way. The championship rounds, 10, 11 and 12 to go. Uncharted waters for the challenger, that man, Hugo Pineda.
Well, Peter, I must admit, I thought the Colombian wouldn't go past 4 or 5 rounds with Kostya, and you know, I watched him train, but I knew he was hiding something, and you know, obviously he's trained very, very hard.
Well, he has. I think he's been on the verge of giving it away several times, but the bell has saved him, certainly at the end of round 7 when he was put down. Let's have a look at the action. There's the grimace on the face of Kostya Zou as a result of another low blow.
Seconds down.
He's awkward, Pineda. He's an awkward customer. 10, 11 and 12 to go. Uncharted waters, as I said, for Hugo Pineda. Not so for Kostya Zou.
Doesn't just stick out the jab and move. Jab and move.
He certainly looks better when he does that, Shannon.
Yeah, well, that's right. You know, Costa's fight is to get inside because he is the smaller man. The Colombian has not used his reach advantage at all during the fight. Certainly got a tough chin. That left hook by Costa was smack on it.
Yeah, he's taken some punches, hasn't he? And he's still there in round 10. I don't think Billy Miles will accept any more low blows. It's tough enough for Pineda to be close to Zou without giving away points in several rounds. And that's automatically made some rounds 10-8. To Kostya Zou, plus the two knockdown were 10-8 rounds. So he's going to be doing it very tough to get near Zou, even though he won the first round by virtue of a knockdown.
Well, Kostya is well on top. On points, that's obvious, but he's still relentless, still attacking the Colombian. He only knows one way, and that's straightforward, Kostya Zou.
Kostya's always had that unusual habit of breathing through his mouth when he fights, and I've never seen a fighter that has his mouth open as much as Kostya Zou. Obviously, it doesn't affect him anyway because he's had such a wonderful career as an amateur and now as a pro with this, his 16th professional fight.
Another good right hand there by Kostya Zou. Yes, it's a trait that Justin Rousell, the Australian junior welterweight champion, seems to have adopted as well, his training partner.
Even at the moment, Kostya with a mouth wide open.
Stalking his opponent, looking for the target, cocking the right hand. Oh, the left.
He's well on top, Kostya Zou.
Yeah, pacing himself well now. Pineda not throwing enough. Blood coming from the nostril, the right nostril of, or both nostrils really, as a result of the right hands that is received from Kostya Zou. Just switch hitting a bit, the southpaw. Hitting Kostya Zou with the left.
Seems to have lacked or lost some of the power in his punches, Kostya.
Walking
stepping forward,
yeah.
Not concerned at all.
Walking through them, Kostya Zou. The end of round 10.
End of round number 10.
There's the gauze going up the nose of Hugo Pineda. Long way back to Colombia, and he'll be a sick and sorry boy tomorrow morning. He's copped a lot of punishment, deserves 100 out of 100 for courage. He's come to fight. It was always tough to meet Kostya Zou in his own backyard, his adopted backyard here in Sydney, Australia. He's done well, Pineda, but with every round, his challenge for his dream of a world title is disappearing.
Seconds down, round number 11.
Round 11, oh, right by Zou, buckled him again at the knees. Pineda hanging on, a left by Kostya Zou off the clinch. He's got him in his blue corner, but Pineda gets back in the centre ring. Good right by Pineda, and back went the water out of Kostya Zou. A ponytail gushed a bit of water out of it there like a little mini geyser.
Pineda's bleeding very, very heavy from the nose at the moment.
Well, he's had about two dozen right-hand specials from Kostya Zou. They've tried to stop it, but... Ah, back went
nice
the
left
Zou.
Hand.
A good left hand. He hasn't thrown many of them. Switch hitting Pineda and catching Kostya Zou by surprise. But it only serves to spur Kostya on. The pit bull against the praying mantis. And the little pity is doing his breed proud. Hope you're enjoying the action wherever you are. around Australia on Premier All Star Sports. The number one supporter of boxing in Australia. Special cheerio too to our overseas boxing fans watching the bout through Prime in North and South America, United States, and also through Asia. Down he goes, left hand from Koshizu. And Pineda courageously gets to his feet. Knocked down in round 11, another left from Koshizu. He wants to finish it here and now. Down goes Pineda again.
Carl Bruce are telling him to keep going. He looked over. He doesn't want
down
to continue,
again.
I don't think.
Three times.
And it's all over.
In round 9. In round 11. Three knockdowns in round 11. And the fight is all over. Pineda, a sorry sight on the canvas. Be consoled by the referee, Billy Miles. And pandemonium has broken out in centre ring here. Parramatta Stadium. I have never seen so many in the ring. Koshizu, his dad is in the ring. Koshizu is in the ring. His dad trying to get to him. An absolute pandemonium in the ring here. I have never seen so many people in a ring, in a fight, anywhere in the world. That is just crazy.
Well, it's just
unbelievable. Where have they come from? I mean, spectators have hopped in the ring here. Koshizu, a jubilant retention of the IBF Junior Welterweight Championship of the World. Two knockdowns in round 11. Three KOs in round 11. So it was five times to the canvas for Hugo Pineda. Once to Koshizu. And Billy Miles trying to retain some order in centre ring here at Parramatta Stadium. It is absolute pandemonium. Koshizu retaining his IBF Junior Welterweight Championship, and Shannon Taylor very impressively.
Yeah, it's a very good win by Koshizu to get off the deck in the first round. And now he showed he's a champion. He's come back and won the fight in good fashion.
Yeah, he certainly has. And in centre ring, it's absolute pandemonium. As I've repeatedly said, there have got to be 60 people in centre ring there at the moment.
It's rock and roll wrestling at its best.
It certainly is. I mean, let's go to centre ring now with Mark Warren and Koshizu.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2 minutes and 38 seconds in the 11th round, by means of KO and still IBF Junior Welterweight Champion of the World, the baby-faced assassin, Koshizu. If everyone could step back,
well,
Costa can see the crowd, so the crowd can have a talk to Costa.
I think I've called about 20 world title fights. That's an absolute disgrace what's happened in centre ring there. Great performance by Koshizu. But there's an Etsy army in there. Absolute army of people in the ring.
His wife Natasha in tears in the ring as well.
Can all the photographers please stand back near the
very impressive display by Koshizu. They were critical of him during his first offence against Roger Mayweather. Well, he certainly has put all that behind him. The problems, the safety security reasons, he didn't go to Colombia, and he has shown he is a true champion there.
He is. Shannon Taylor, you've stated repeatedly you'd love to fight Koshizu. How do you feel after that performance?
Well, it hasn't changed. I feel the Costas had a good win tonight. I know that I'm going back to the gym Monday morning and I'll train harder and harder again.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I was impressed, but
we'll come back to that, Shannon. Let's go into centre ring with Mark Warren, a very excited Mark Warren, with Kostyuzu.
11 rounds, Hugo Pineda. He came here to fight and probably lived even above your expectations.
I knew he's a good fighter. I knew he's very tough, smart, very awkward because he's very tall. Very hard to catch him properly. And he's South American, he's all tough. I know Hector, and he's very tough like him, and that's why it was very hard to knock him down properly. And I catch him many, many times with very good shots, but he was very strong.
Looking at you now, the Colombian, that reach advantage, and as you said, he was tough. He caught you a couple of times throughout the fight.
I don't believe it myself. I was being knocked down the first time. And
did you think it was a slip?
No, I didn't think it's slip. And he catch me very good, but I wasn't good straight away. I know I'm tough, but it's a lucky punch because I didn't see him, and that's the result.
Early in the fight, he hit the canvas, and it was an almighty punch. I didn't think he was going to get up. He did. A tough customer.
He come here to win the title. That's why we can wait from him something special, and he did. He was recovering very well, and he's very, very tough. I'd like to thank all people here. Thank you very much for your support.
They said, he's thanking you, folks. They said that they wouldn't get a crowd to Parramatta Stadium. Well, there's a last count, 11,500 people that will say they're wrong. The people of Parramatta and Sydney's West certainly love the baby-faced assassin, Kostyuzu.
Oh, nothing, not ways and nothing can stop us. Thank you very much for your support.
One more question.
Kostyuzu in centre ring, and have a look at centre ring. Have you ever seen as many people in centre ring before? I certainly haven't. Let's go to the replay of the knockdown.
Five fights in 1996. What's next? And will you
first
come
of three, and down he went.
After this is awesome.
The
really
right
sure
did the damage in most of the knockdowns, Shannon.
Yeah, all night long after the first round onwards, Costa was landing the right hand frequently, and it just kept taking its toll.
Certainly did. There was the second time that Pineda went down. And you've got to remember, this guy has never been beaten in an amateur and professional career. And look at the pain on his face. He is a defeated fighter, a gallant fighter, but there's an experience that he's never had to feel, Shannon.
Well, that's right, Peter. I think you said earlier in the fight, he'd never fought out of South America and Colombia. And Costa has, and I think that's where the experience and took its toll.
Well, it certainly did, John Casey. All the drama of a world title fight. We expected it, we got it. It was a dramatic day from the time we arrived with the weather. The attempted assassination of Shannon Taylor from us in terms of his exit from the commentary position by Kostyuzu's promoter, Brad Wharton. You survived that one, Shannon. You've been part of our team since we've been calling fighting. You've been very much welcome, and I can't believe that was attempted here tonight. Okay, so there it is. There's the scene here now. Moments after Kostyuzu had a three-time knockdown in round 11, three KOs in round 11 to retain his world IBF championship here before a good crowd. They said 11, I think about five or six here.